Ayan.
Oh, let me know if you see na, ha?
Yes, we can see. We're now actually live. Hi, everyone. Good morning, Philippines, and everyone in the entire world who we get to reach with this platform. Good morning, guys. Good morning, Shirley.
Hi, good morning, Ralph.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. We are excited, very excited to start this special episode. This is in the initiative of New Bold You, and of course the initiative of hashtag Mental Health PH, and of course the New Beginnings. We're very excited about this because this is the first time that we're doing this. Bold Moments originally is a weekly show,
mm-hmm.
pero yeah. everything turned around 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Dami nangyari. I remember we were busy, we were doing groceries. I was in cash and carry 2 weeks ago. And then I just feel that there's something in the air that is going to change. But I didn't know that this is how everything will transpire. And now we're living in the era of COVID. Mm-hmm. And these are very challenging times because right now, we are not really equipped. Diba, Shirley, about...
Yes.
Right in these times, it's very uncertain. It's very something that that is unprecedented. Nothing like this happened before. So, paano na to? How can we, how can we?
Yeah, talagang 360, Ralph, no? Yung nangyari sa atin ngayon. Like, kung last week or last 2 weeks ago, nakakapag-grocery ka pa, nakakapunta ka pa sa mall, nakakasakay ka pa with MRT, but right now, talagang totally, no, naka-quarantine. Everybody... is the government is telling the people to stay at their house,
yes.
and the movement's really limited. So talagang nakaka-shock talaga siya. Talagang new environment.
So parang this is the challenge of our times, of our generation, and we are not allowing this time or these challenges to dampen our spirit. We are not that type of people. We know we are better than this.
Yeah.
So we are doing an initiative with the help of NBU, with the help of hashtag Mental Health PH, and of course our resource speaker, every day, starting today, except Sundays, because Sundays is a worship, we are going to do a live episode every 11:30. This is going to be the new norm for now during the era of COVID. And I'm so happy, Shirley. Thank you for joining me, for becoming part as my co-host for this.
Yes. It's an honor, Ralph.
Yes. Kasi why are we here? What we're doing is providing a platform. We're bringing the experts, the doctors, the people who has information and wisdom, mm-hmm. and bridge the gap so that we can bridge them to you and through a variety of topics that's very relevant. It's very important for us to thrive in these times. All right.
Yes.
So
I think the topic for this morning is very interesting because everybody really struggling with this kind of outbreak. Nababaliw na yung mga tao, ang dami-dami nang iniisip, konting sakit lang ng lalamunan, they feel na do I have COVID? So imagine kung ilang araw mo na yung iniinda tapos wala kang makausap, wala kang mapagtanungan. So ano yung dapat mong gawin?
That's true. And I'm so, we're so honored. It's such a privilege to have this morning a great doctor going to help us with all of this. I'm not equipped. Are you equipped, Shirley?
Not really. Okay, I'm very excited for this talk.
Yeah, I know. We're semi-equipped. We can Google, but it's really different when you have an expert. But we have a doctor who's mm-hmm. really very knowledgeable about this domain. So without further ado, let me introduce him. So we are going to have this morning the consultant, a consultant in Medical City about his expertise is adult and child psychiatry. He's also affiliated with Mental Health PH, a movement that is designed to help people raise awareness on mental health and help people become emotionally and mentally resilient. I'd like to thank Roy from Mental Health PH for helping us invite Dr. Kenneth this morning. He's also a fellow of the Philippine Psychiatric Association. He's also a fellow of the Philippine Society for Child and Adolescent Psychiatry. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Kenneth Jabate. Hi, Doc.
Hi, Doc. Good morning.
Good morning. Hello, Ralph and Shirley. Thanks for inviting me.
No, thank you for
for your time. This is a very busy for you for sure, but you really give us more time to thank you, babe. To,
hi, baby.
You know,
hi baby. That's Zoe, by the way, guys. That's Zoe.
To work from home.
Work from home, iba talaga.
Yeah, so Doc, we would like to thank you, and we really appreciate us giving your time for this very important topic.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Yes, Doc, let's start, no? Kasi right now, we can go to many directions. Pero mental health is still somehow a vague concept for everybody. Can you define for us what mental health is all about?
Okay. So I think, yeah, we have an idea kasi that mental health, it's about mental illness, parang what you see in the movies, mga ganun. But I think we have to realize that mental health is something we all share, because the definition is, it's ultimately a state of well-being. Kaginhawaan sa Tagalog, no? Which affects how we feel, how we think, how we behave. So mental health allows us to live fruitfully, to work productively, and to contribute to our communities. So, and especially relevant now, mental health allows us to help cope with the stresses of life. And one very big stress of life that we are all facing right now is this COVID-19 crisis. So mental health is something that is very much part of our lives and we need to take care of.
That's true. Doc, it's a very... It's a topic that is a bit taboo to people. Like, before we give them tips on how to be resilient, why is this a taboo for people to openly discuss about mental health with their friends and relatives or people close to them?
I think before, kasi it had a lot with stigma. Like, what we understand exactly about mental health is all of those severe, impossible to treat, very scary types of manifestations of mental health problems. So unfortunately, we tend, I feel that parang yun for the longest time yun yung nagiging perception ng tao about mental health. Although I'm glad to know that that's changing nowadays. People are realizing, as we said, that it's not out there. It's with all of us here. So we do have to realize that mental health is something that we all have. And that's like, sabi ng WHO, the World Health Organization, the definition of health is not just physical, but mental as well. Mental, social, spiritual. So there's no health without mental health.
That's true. And I am so happy that we are now opening ourselves, our minds, to also address this. Because before, when you have a sugat, we go to the hospital. And then we get it relieved. But when it comes to the state of the mind, we really don't have much to talk to. Now we have doctors like you who we can talk to about this. So we're very, we're very thankful for you and all of these doctors who's been helping out with this. Doc, about COVID-19, do you get reports about people who are going through some mental or emotional problems in these times?
Yes, definitely. There are a lot of reports. I see it in the news. People who have been isolated, and in terms of their responses, we know that in China, which dealt with this COVID crisis a long time before, not so long ago, but it seems like a lifetime away, no? there was a public mental health crisis ongoing alongside all of the in terms of their responses to mental health. So ako, I mean, I don't just see it in terms of the news that we hear about, but in my work. So I've been doing video consultations with a lot of my patients at this point. A lot of them are feeling, the effects of this crisis in terms of their own mental health, and it's becoming a challenge for them. And I'm also seeing new patients at this point that they've been doing well so far. Kaso, this crisis, kumbaga, pushed them to the limit and therefore has been the trigger in terms of a lot of clinical mental health problems like clinical depression and anxiety disorders. So yeah, definitely there's a lot going on out there.
Well, that's a really good data. Kasi napapansin ko karamihan how families, Filipino families, respond to someone who's going through this is magpakatatag ka, kaya mo yan.
Yeah. Tapos be strong.
Diba? Be strong. Pero how is it really to be strong?
That's true.
What if we go beyond our limit and baka mamaya go out of, diba? We'll go crazy. Doc, how can we start, how can we cope in this,
right.
Example, the common people now who are not really going through something but they're getting here.
So I've been telling a lot of my patients, and I think it's applicable for everybody at this point. So the phrase that I say is, it's okay not to be okay, given what's happening. So this is a crisis unlike any other our country and our world has faced. So it's a very common response to feel stressed and worried. So actually, psychologically speaking, I'd like to summarize the consequences of the COVID pandemic into words. No? So they are uncertainty and isolation. So the first, we are uncertain of many things right now. Like for example, our families, ourselves, our friends will fall ill. We're uncertain of what will happen to our work, our livelihoods, now and parang in the next coming months. No, I mean, we are also, I'm sure a lot of us are also, I know I am, that uncertain whether those who are in power are actually making the right decisions in terms of taking care of all of us and not just themselves. So there's a lot of uncertainty. So, and the other thing is isolation, because, you know, ang hirap ng COVID kasi the prevention and treatment requires us to separate ourselves from other people in so many ways. So we can't see aside from our nuclear families, which we're supposed to stay with, so
there's
we can't
no support see our system, though, no?
Yeah, it's hard to tap into the usual sources and means of support. So like we can't benefit from human touch, which is comforting. When we do have to go out, we interact with strangers. There's people are wearing masks, so we can't see. We can't benefit from the from the warmth of human connection, even among strangers. And this is something that our patients right now in the hospital are experiencing. When you are in the hospital, for example, you have to be alone. Your family is separated from you. So the people who are taking care of you are wearing face shields, they're wearing masks, you can't see them. And so there's a lot of isolation in so many ways that are going on. So therefore, I mean, how can one expect to be just fine at this point?
Yes.
So we have to recognize that to an extent, it's okay not to be okay. And just have to see parang ano ba yung what I call the thin red line? Because, you know, mental health, as you see, you know, I'm a psychiatrist. So of course, I deal with pathologies, no? Parang what is the thin red line of what is, you know, normal mental health and a normal response in the midst of an abnormal situation versus something that needs more intensive treatment or intervention.
I love what you said earlier, Doc. Surely you can also join your questions about mental health. I'll just interrupt sandali. What you said earlier, I love. It's okay to not be okay. Kasi people nowadays, especially us, our default selves, we will judge ourselves that there's something wrong with me. I'm not feeling good. I cannot see clearly. I feel like I'm in a dark place right now and I'm by myself. And I think there's something wrong. But when you said it's okay to not be okay, I think that's a really good line there. Thank you, Doc, for that. Yes. So, Doc, for example, so what you said earlier, yung support system natin that we used to have before, we get to talk to our friends, we get to talk to our family, we get to meet you or doctor in person. Pero right now, we have to isolate ourselves. We have to stay at home. What can we do to connect socially, warm somehow, to connect with other people?
Okay. Well, I guess what I was saying a while ago, the means are different. Okay. So there are so many ways that we are used to, lalo na Pilipino tayo, we connect eh, parang especially in terms of being with other people physically. But that's not an option at this point. But fortunately, I mean, unlike pandemics in ages past, we do have mechanisms like this to be able to reach out to people. So we do have to take advantage of that. Kami mga psychiatrists, actually, we are used very much to dealing with people on a face-to-face basis. Because there's really, it's the most ideal. I mean, there's nothing like it, but we have to adapt it. So I think, so that's why we've had to do like e-consultations, for example, in terms of work. But I think we can apply the lessons of this in our daily lives, that we do have to take advantage of technology, like in terms of social media, technology like this, video conferencing, to be able to reach out. So WHO mentioned the original term was social distancing. But they've actually, they're encouraging us to replace that term from social distancing to physical distancing, because that's better. Identifying that we don't have to really, it doesn't mean that we're physically apart, that we have to socially distance ourselves from the people who we care for. So we do have to take advantage of these mechanisms, especially those who are kumbaga, are at risk in terms of their mental health because of the situation.
Yes, I replace lang what you said. I love that when you said that it's actually much better now because we have means to communicate. We have our phones. We can call someone. We can be on social media and we can interact with other people. We are not fully alone. We are just somehow, because we're needed to be, we're distanced physically, which is fine, though it sucks somehow. Sorry for the term, it's French. Yeah. But we get to connect with people through Zoom. And this is even better than compared to pandemics before, where you have to really physically isolate yourself without any social community.
Yeah.
Shirley, can you share? I think we have a lot of viewers now. We peaked, I think, at around 120 viewers today.
Yeah, I think, sa akin, Doc, it's really more of, kung ako naman, for example, yung nakaka-experience, no? Yung na-share ko nga kanina, yung aunt ko, we're able to get her last Monday, no? Kasi parang, she's not telling anybody. She just disclosed that to me over the phone. Na the reason why pala na ayaw niyang dinadalaw siya or pinupuntahan siya ng mother ko, kasi meron pala siyang nararamdaman, which is medyo itchy yung throat niya. And then, tinanong ko siya, nasabi ko sa kanya na bakit hindi ka nalang magpunta dito or puntahan ka namin. Parang she keep us pushing. Parang pinupush niya kami aside and telling us na pag pumunta kayo dito, dapat nakamask kayo. So parang yun na yung naging parang point ko na may mali siguro dun sa mga iniisip niya. No, yun pala, parang she's suffering that for 3 days already. So, nung pinuntahan namin siya, doon na niya sinabi sa akin na ayaw niya makipag-usap sa mga tao kasi natatakot siya na baka mamaya makahawa daw siya. So, nung tinanong ko, ba't ano ba yung nararamdaman mo? She told me na masakit daw yung lalamunan niya.
Uh-oh.
And parang 3 days na siya nag-isolate. So, nung tinignan ko naman yung history niya, kasi Doc, I'm a nurse by profession. Since may nilabas din naman kasi si DOH na algorithm, kinompare ko siya and nakita ko naman talaga na hindi naman siya potentially possible na COVID patient dahil wala rin naman kasi siyang exposure to COVID, hindi rin naman siya nag-grocery kasi senior citizen na rin siya, hindi rin siya na-expose. So, through that conversation, kahit papano, na-encourage ko siya to talk with other people also. And right now, nandito siya sa akin ngayon, as in sa bahay ko. Kasi yung feeling niya na parang ayaw niya makipagsalamuha sa iba, tapos ginugusto na lang niya na kimkimin na lang sa sarili niya kung ano yung nararamdaman niya. And I think, ang question ko doon is, paano kung halimbawa wala siya or wala siyang mga kamag-anak or makausap within that household? Hindi ko ma-imagine kung ano yung itsura ng taong yon, no, na parang hindi man COVID yung papatay sa kanya, but anxiety will gonna kill her.
That's a good point. Anxiety can kill people more than COVID.
Yes. And then siguro kahit wala siyang sakit, because of that kind of thinking, definitely magma-manifest yun, di ba, through physical diseases. Like, siguro magkakaroon siya ng mga headache, tataas yung BP niya, and those stuff. So, siguro yun, Doc, ano ba yung pwede nating gawin kung halimbawa, or paano ba tayo magiging more sensitive also for our household kung meron nakaka-experience nun? Or meron ba kayong marirecommend, Doc, na ano ba yung mga signs and symptoms na baka mamaya nagsasuffer na pala yung mga family members natin na hindi rin natin alam?
Okay. Well, siguro, I mean, to be able to answer that as a psychiatrist, I'll answer first as a medical doctor as well, no? So, I think in terms of that example, we do have to be very mindful in the same way na there's no physical health without mental health. There's no mental health without physical health. So as a medical doctor, we do have to be very informed about kung ano yung recommendations in terms of ano ba yung tamang precautions, especially with our people who are at risk. Siguro, yung worry lang natin kasi ngayon, number one, maraming asymptomatic infections can be a source of spread. So as much as possible, we do have to really follow as much as possible the prescriptions in terms of physical distancing and if necessary, isolation and quarantine from those who might be possible. Kasi we don't know eh. I mean, and the reality is, even in terms of there are the worrying news for me as a medical doctor is there are a lot of mild or even asymptomatic cases. So important talaga yung physical distancing. We cannot negotiate with that reality, no? Oh, pero you know, therefore moving past that, yun nga, I do agree that anxiety can. That can manifest in a lot of ways because it's also very feasible that that our anxiety responses are not just you know mental and emotional but also physical. Yeah. So anxiety when it's very very severe can lead to headaches for those with asthma. For example, I have asthma myself, so. Because I have been anxious over the past few days, I've been noticing it's my chest has been a little bit tightening up. So it's most likely asthma. But because that's how powerful the brain can get. Okay, but of course you don't know. So we do have to be careful. Yeah. So I think at this point, it still goes back to using the mechanisms that are available to us. I mean, aside from, of course, the precautions that we have to do if somebody might be experiencing symptoms, because we do have to be careful. We can't presume at this point, because as a medical doctor, parang it's. I don't think we have. We're fully understanding the community spread. That's the reality of it. So we have to be careful physically. But therefore, what can we do in terms of taking precautions? In terms of reaching out using these mechanisms: social media, text, a telephone call. And getting them to talk, eh. Like with the example of your tita, parang it's the stigma of like of perhaps what's going on. That's why she's not just physically isolating herself, but socially isolating herself. So hindi naman porket that nararamdaman niya yon, yun nga. But we should that it's a very common response to like emotionally isolate yourself. But we have to give the message. That number one, we have to remove the stigma. Like if you have COVID, it doesn't mean that you are that we should abandon them, okay, yeah. Or that we should be fearful of them. In fact, we should be more proactive in terms and creative in terms of ways to take care of them and reach out to them. So I hope that's the message that we can send to the public at this point. Kasi ang daming I mean, ako, yun nga, I'm in the healthcare field. Kawawa yung mga people who are, mga, for example, nurses are being turned out of their dormitories by their landlords because of that fear. But yun nga, how to get that right balance between like physical distancing and precautions and social distancing? in terms of reaching out to them. So hopefully we can, we have to think of how we will do that in terms of our own settings.
Doc, I love that very much. I think the keyword with what you said earlier is compassion. Have compassion for others who might be suffering, who might be going through this. And for people who are already is diagnosed with COVID, if they do have COVID, you do not abandon them. Yeah. Kasi yun ang nangyayari is like, ngayon, ang state of mind na karamihan is survival mode. Like, I want to live. If you do are infected, I'll get away from you and I won't even take care of you. Mas masakit yun kapag it's coming from your family members na who will abandon you. So, by applying compassion and by being a real human being, being your higher self, you have to address this by taking care of people. We have to look out for each other. Thank you very much for that, Doc. I'd like to recognize the people who are viewing and are watching us right now. Let's say hi to them, Doc. Hey, everyone. And we have around 135 people who are watching. Wow. From where you are, guys, please tell us your location. If you're outside the country, ducks.
We have one from Hong Kong. I saw one from Hong Kong.
Hey, guys. Hi, people from Hong Kong. I hope you guys are doing well there. And to people who are at their homes right now, hello po. Thank you very much for watching. I know it's rare for you to be in the office, so you're at home. Hi, guys, at home.
And Ralph, if they have any questions, they can drop it in the comment section and then we will try to answer that as much as we can.
Yes, yes.
Tapos yun siguro, Doc, follow-up question ko lang, Doc, no? Meron ba tayong mga signs and symptoms na pwedeng ma-observe dito sa mga family members natin na baka kasi mamaya akala natin hindi pa pa, alam mo yun, meron na silang anxiety and or nade-depress na sila about the situation. What can be the the signs and symptoms,
right,
na pwede nating observe dito sa mga family members natin para we are all aware on how can we best support them?
Okay. So, I mean, that's a very common question when I give talks in terms of mental health, no? Kailan na ba kailangang magpatingin or kailangan ng intervention? So, the thin red line really is functionality. Okay? So, I think that's the important term, eh? Because, well, it's easy enough to determine that somebody is unwell. Now, for example, if they're not in touch with the reality, or, I mean, meaning, like, they have beliefs na parang medyo kakaiba na they have sensory experience that are that are not normal, as it were, no? Or for example, another way is if they're already thinking of harming themselves, obvious naman that may mental health problem na. Okay, but I guess the important delineation in terms of, as I said, yung discussion natin about normal parang stress responses, the being worried and being sad about things, is really, if somebody is sad and worried for an extended period of time to the point that they cannot function in terms of their responsibilities. So like, for example, if weeks go by, natuloy-tuloy na yung sadness and yung worry, or yung worry that hindi na nila magampanan yung roles. I mean, they can fulfill their roles as parents, as family members, or for example, those who are working from home, if it's stopping them from working productively, or for example, students, if they can study already for an extended period of time, that's the sign for me that functionality is already affected. So that's the red flag, and that's how people. That's probably when it might benefit from assessment by a professional and from intervention.
Okay, Doc. So I have someone in my home, a family member or a friend of mine who's going through this. However, it's hard for us to find a psychiatrist like you, or hard for us to go to the hospital because maybe we are all fearful to go to the hospital
right now.
COVID. What are the first aid measures that we can do at our homes to address,
right? Oh, So how to talk to somebody who might be going through the problem, no? Okay, so actually the answer is don't talk too much. and instead listen and ask, okay? Or reach out to them. And really, I mean, if you're going to talk, it's not so much to lecture them or whatever, but to ask how they are and give them the opportunity, a safe space to be able to ventilate their emotions, their thoughts, their fears, no? So, and, you know, it doesn't take a mental health license or a professional to be able to do this. Just, as I said, think of you, talk to people with compassion and with kindness and allow them the opportunity to air out, to ventilate what they're feeling right now and validate that. So actually, that opportunity is one of the biggest secrets of psychological first aid. And the advantage of that in getting them to open up is that you will be able to determine, yun nga, that if they're at that point where in the thin red line, that I would say, if they are still kaya pa naman or if they need help already.
Yeah.
I like that very much. Airing lang your side if you are going through depression or if you feel that you're emotionally challenged at these times, by sharing lang, by venting out what's happening, you can somehow relieve what you're going through.
Yeah, that's very therapeutic.
So we have now one question coming from our viewers right now.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much, guys. Again, thank you again to hashtag MentalHealthPH for helping us out for this episode. From Imelin Kasaljay, how can we help our frontliners such as nurses like myself? A lot of us is scared because we have to put it aside because we need to serve our patients. Wow. By the way, first of all, I'd like to salute you guys. You guys in the front line, you are doing such an amazing job taking care of all of us. Thank you very much for your help and for doing what you're doing. So for that, Doc, ano yung magagawa ng mga nurses who are fearful but needs to do their duty?
Right. Oh, I mean, as like you, I also salute all of the nurses and the frontliners at this point, no?
Mm-hmm.
Who are taking care of us and doing an amazing job at the risk to their well-being and to their own health, no? So, well, I guess on a personal level, I mean, what I would suggest is really, you know, allow yourself to experience all of your emotions. So the fact that you are experiencing all of these negative emotions does not mean that you're not okay. You don't have to be perfect at this point, no? And secondly, please do exercise self-care, okay? When you can and when the opportunity presents itself, take care of your body, eat right, engage in wellness activities like meditation and breathing exercises. So, I mean, and there are resources on social media, very good ones, like that one can find. Mental Health PH has that, has some resources there. My department, the Medical City Center for Behavioral Health, has a Facebook page where there are some quick guides in terms of self-care tips. Because actually, this comes from... This actually came about. We're doing this because our department is actually very focused on initiatives right now. So all of us psychiatrists in terms of helping the people in our hospital. So we have a lot of different mechanisms that we're trying to provide creative ways to support those who are in the front lines. So I guess, well, this is not for the questions who are asking, the person who's asking, because but more for people who are their leaders who are in positions to make some change to make some programs. Please do find ways to support the mental health of your frontliners. That is just as important, I think, in terms of ensuring their safety.
Yeah, I think that's very important, Doc, no? Oo. Lalo na, for example, syempre sila nurse, hindi rin naman sila immortal. Yun nga yung lagi kong nababasa ngayon, Doc, sa mga posts nila. they're not immortals. They have also the emotions. But I think what's important is like what you've said, no? Practice deep breathing exercises. Maybe perhaps also recognize their emotions and their feelings.
Yeah.
And I think it's very also important na pag-usapan din, magkaroon din siguro, Doc, ng mga, parang mga post-talk sessions right after duties, which I think banggit mo rin yun, Doc, kanina. Yeah.
Get the support of your, you can reach out to your colleagues and find ways to ventilate your emotions. Because especially those who are, makamagulat kayo, kala nyo parang kayo lang yung parang stressed or parang not handling it well. Pero a lot of your colleagues are. So parang draw strength from each other. And ako, yun nga, for the people who are listening here who are not part of that, yun nga, take a special effort to think who in your social networks might be in the front lines. I mean, not just healthcare workers, but also those who do have to be out and do essential essential services in terms of their physical presence, like people working in banks, people who are working in the food industry, who do have to who don't have the benefit of quarantining. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, aside from just staying at home, if you don't really need to, please reach out to them because they will appreciate your support. Alaking
That's
bagay.
Very important. That's true. Eto, Doc, mayroon ding isang question from Juan Christian, which I think is very valid and it's very common to the household, no? Paano daw po kung yung family member ang ayaw mag-share?
Mm-mm. Okay. Hindi naman natin mapipilit yun, that we should respect the autonomy of the person in that case, no? Pero when we say that somebody is not sharing, baka naman we might consider kung pag-isipan natin ano kaya yung circumstances kung bakit hindi siya comfortable. So we do have to set the stage, kumbaga, metaphorically speaking, we do have to provide a safe space in terms of asking them to share. You know, so yun nga, some people are not afraid to share because they are feeling nila when they share, bibigyan lang sila ng advice, yun nga parang hindi sila pakikinggan. So we do have to communicate to somebody who, if we really want them to share, we must be ready to listen. I think that's we have to communicate that when we want somebody to share is that we're here to kind of listen primarily. Mm-hmm. And I think maraming mga tao na malaking hurdle yun for a lot of people who are afraid to share. Kasi a lot of them, they feel, you know, when they share something, they parang pagsasabihan na sila or they get a lot of advice, which is not that bad. You know? But minsan kasi it's not so helpful to give so much advice if we don't fully understand what's going on. So providing them that space.
Okay, Doc.
I like that, Doc. No, lahat tayo, a lot of us, once meron some of us are going through something, we give them advice right away without even inquiring what's happening. Sometimes, kasi by listening alone, that relieves already. And only when they fully vent out that you can now provide your advice and not judging, not coming from a space of judgment. No? Mm-hmm. I love that very much. Doc, meron akong tanong kasi right now, I have a data, no, coming from Facebook that 80% of SMEs are going through a difficult time now. Entrepreneurs are having a hard time surviving because they have a really, you know, challenged cash flow right now.
Yeah.
And we don't see the light in the tunnel so far because it's not ending this crisis, and they're panicking. A lot of entrepreneurs are panicking. Even the employees, of course, they're going through this. Parang paano yung hanap buhay namin?
Exactly.
Doc, this might be asking beyond your pay grade, pero baka you could provide us with some tips or ideas on how.
Kala ko the solution. Can go through
something. Well, the solution, as I said, most of the time, what I can best provide is, a listening ear. Aside from that, well, let me validate again, that is all normal. It's because of the uncertainty of the situation. So it's just really being aware and accepting within yourself that this is a response that is normal at this point. And allow and not deny yourself those feelings, okay? And I think because of that, like, negative emotions, parang one way to think of it, they're like uninvited guests in our lives, no? But the more that we run away from these uninvited guests, like if you think of like our being as like we're houses and then they're knocking on the door, the more we ignore them, the more nangungulit sila and the more they don't go away. It might be helpful to allow yourself to welcome that negative emotion, to experience it, to be in the moment and recognize that that is going on. Take a breath and stay with the emotion. And because afterwards, you know, allowing yourself to stay with that emotion, hindi na yung parang emotional brain lang natin yung, we allow the emotional, the signals from the emotional brain parang to dissipate, and then allow our thinking brain to parang step in. Because at the end of the day, you know, we will have to parang find creative ways to be able to get through this. Oh, so I mean, allowing ourselves the space to just go through that emotions will give us hopefully the strength of will and parang energy to face it in terms of actions, the appropriate actions. Because
so it's really more of an ad hoc, no? Recognizing the feelings, no? And then let it sink in.
Yeah,
exactly. I think that's part of the process, no? Hindi kasi pwede na, okay, after ito, pagtulog ko nito, wala na yung sadness. Kailangan because talaga i-proceso.
I mean, it's when I say to my patients, like, for example, somebody who has a clinical anxiety, the goal is not for you to treat your anxiety by removing it altogether. The goal of the treatment is to be able to, for you to tolerate the anxiety and be able to function, to be able to live your best life, but while working and living with the anxiety. So I'm finding that balance, you know, because, you know, the situation, you know, we don't know, but we do have to act for ourselves, for our families, for our colleagues. So hopefully allowing ourselves and not denying this is the first step.
That's true. Eto, Doc, Ralph, we have a question from Coach Val. Hi, Coach Val. Doc, there are apps now, mostly from the West, that provide professional psychiatric help to people either via chat or video or voice conference. Mm-hmm. What do you think about this? Do we have a similar services here in the Philippines?
Okay, yeah. I mean, I'm glad to say that especially there are a lot of initiatives nowadays in terms of the mental health professionals in the local scene that are counterparts of these, no? I mean, I'm not totally familiar with all of the intervention, so it might not be exhaustive. But definitely in terms of the DOH is promoting the hotline in terms of mental health, which is housed in the National Center for Mental Health. So that's for everybody and it's free. Okay. Private organizations and non-governmental organizations are also stepping up their efforts. Like one of the biggest ones, the Philippine Mental Health Association, I just saw in their social media. So they're sort of, during this crisis of the quarantine, they're opening sort of a chat line that they can just chat with so that they can be talk about their problems and parang find resources, no? And you know, aside from this, you know, there are a lot of us right now mental health professionals who are harnessing these capabilities of technology to be able to provide consultations in terms of mental health, telemental health. So for example, at my department, at the Medical City Department of Psychiatry, we're using these very same technologies to provide counseling and psychotherapy. And nowadays, we can provide, like, when it is really necessary. We don't do it for everybody, especially at this time, because sometimes kailangan lang naman is more of a listening ear. But kung may kailangan talaga, we do provide medicine to be able to help. And there are ways that we can transmit that.
Okay, that's good to hear, Doc. And I think we also have another question. Yes, Rag.
Yes, one third question. Ikaw na lang, dear, si kay Chin Bilao. Ano ba? Tama ba?
Ano, you go ahead first.
Yes. Chin Bilao, meron siyang question, Doc. The physical symptoms of anxiety can be the same as COVID. It's the same question with Teen Padisho. Sabi niya, can COVID-19 symptoms in any way be the same as having an anxiety attack?
Well, okay. So an anxiety attack is usually a very intense and discrete event, meaning parang kumbaga like bugso siya, whether it's triggered by it's triggered or it comes out of nowhere. So intense anxiety, difficulty of breathing, for example. So in a way, at that moment, it can feel like it, but I think in terms of COVID, like it has a very distinct profile in terms of yung physical symptoms natin, like cough, fever, for example. That, I mean, that is persistent, no? So that I think it can manifest at, for example, attacks in the same way at the same time, but especially if it's consistent already, makikita naman natin yon. I guess what we do have to watch out for, because, you know, for example, it doesn't mean that it's an either or thing, because people who, I mean, may have COVID at this point, it doesn't mean that they are, hindi sila pwede magkaroon ng anxiety themselves. Okay, because actually, if you have, if you may have COVID, the anxiety, parang the experience of anxiety may exacerbate it. So we do have to manage the anxiety regardless. Okay. So, I mean, and yun nga, parang ako at the end of the day, listen to, there is no way at this point to effectively clinically diagnose. Like for ako, psychiatrist ako, kakausapin ko yung patient. Ah, hindi yan COVID, anxiety. Yan definitively, okay? So I would say still, the best way to harness that anxiety, whether you have COVID or not, is to be able to manage it. Because if you manage your anxiety well, regardless of whatever physical illness you may have, you will be able to manage your physical illness well and get better faster.
Yeah, that's true.
So just listen to follow the advice of our authorities, the DOH is, and use credible sources. The DOH, the World Health Organization, use their materials. Kasi maraming kumakalat ngayon ng mga fake news, unfortunately, di ba? Na parang, kumbaga, if you can hold your breath, you can hold your breath for 10 seconds, parang wala kang COVID. Unfortunately, di ba parang may ganun ang fiber? Parang unfortunately, kung sana ganun lang eh. But we also don't want, as the medical community also does not want people to have a false sense of security, because that can also be dangerous. So please be informed and use your parang wise judgment in terms of monitoring yourself.
That's true.
Okay, Doc, thank you very much for that. That's true, no? Always rely to reliable sources, because those are the sources that you can really, you know, use na are truly proven by science, and you don't want to listen to, you know, a lot of, you know, different sources that are unverified and might cause you, you know, to be more fearful, no, or panic more.
Exactly.
So thank you very much, Dr. Kenneth. No, I'll just say this. We only have 10 minutes left. There's so much I would love to talk to you for hours, though. But I know we have limited time, and I know that we are just, I know that you're also busy. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank again the team, hashtag Mental Health PH,
under the leadership of Roy
and friends. Guys, thank you very much for helping us out with this. And doing your efforts, I checked your page. Please follow them on Facebook, Mental Health PH. You can see a lot of what they're doing there. If you need tips, yesterday I was scrolling their feeds. Ang daming very actionable tips, right? Like for example, one of them is always focus on what you're grateful for. That can help you change your mental state. That for me really helps. When I feel anxious, it happens all the time. Kasi, for example, things about the business especially and an unforeseen future. I tell myself, Ralph, God is in control, and that by choosing to be grateful, we can be more productive. We can look at the positive side, and I think it's really important, you know? So that's it. Thank you guys from Mental Health PH.
Ralph, meron lang
another doc tanong sila. Go ahead. Sorry.
This one kasi parang he wanted to be anonymous. Pero I think maraming makakarelate dito sa question. Yung question niya kasi, Doc, I would like to ask for advice for extroverts like me who are stuck alone at home and have trouble dealing with isolation.
Yeah.
Also for feeling guilty for being given this privilege of comfort at home while others don't have the same luxury.
Okay. So, two things. So in terms of the first question, ito lang nga. Yun nga, even if those of us who are fortunate to have places where we can safely weather the storm, isolation is a big problem and a risk in terms of our propensity for like depression, for example. So we do have to find creative ways to reach out to our social networks. There are a lot of social networks that I am part of personally that I'm seeing have such a lot of creative initiatives. So yun yung parang having Zoom teleconferences to do a shared activity, for example, like watching a movie together, having a Netflix party, kumbaga, in terms of doing that. There's this very innovative, nakakatuwa. There's this exercise gym in Ortigas called Silangan Fit, and they are doing group workouts via Zoom that they are all doing together, even if they're physically distant. So that strengthens the community in terms of that. So find creative ways to work through the physical distancing. Okay, and the second, yun nga, parang in terms of the guilt. Okay, I'd like to quote this one. I posted on my wall because it's the Facebook wall because it really struck a chord in me. Okay, this is from a surgeon in New York who is writing about her own experience in terms of that. So, ang advice niya to people: please flatten the curve and stay at home, but please do not go into couch mode. Like everyone, I have moments where imagining the worst possible COVID-19 scenario steals my breath. But cowering in the dark places of our minds doesn't help. Rather than private panic, we need public-spirited actions. So as I said, we can start from where we are, taking care of those who are close to us at home and then in terms of our network. So reach out to people you love, especially those who might be vulnerable and those who are in the front lines. Again, the healthcare workers and everybody who's doing essential services. But let's also find ways to contribute to the many efforts for our frontliners. Yeah. Private sectors, NGOs are doing a lot of amazing efforts now. If you do have the capacity the extra means, for example, please contribute. And it doesn't require you to be there, donating your GCash points or something. It's as simple as transferring a small amount of money, what may be a small amount of money to you through your online banking app. Mm-hmm. So think of what you can to do something. Kasi ako, like for me, at the early days of it, I've dealt with my own anxiety and my own worries and my own sadness about what's going on. But what has helped me is to focus not on what I cannot do, but what I can do. And I think there are a lot of things that we can do, even if we are physically distancing right now. So let's all support the efforts who are for those who are doing doing that to support our communities right now and our frontliners as well.
I love that, Doc. No, what you said. focus on what you can control, not on what you can't, because by separating them and knowing what you can control, what you can't control, it will give you a sense of belief. Now, what's happening outside of us, the spread of this, maybe what's happening in other countries, you cannot really control that, but you can do control though what's happening in your family. You can help them out in your community. You can help out, share out support, and also you can change your mind, your mental state by becoming more resilient, becoming more proactive and grateful. I love that very much. We are going to, we're very sorry to everyone. We might have to finish our, I know, this very powerful interview. Grabe, a lot of people are watching that. I think we picked around 140 viewers kanina, and now we have around 100 people watching us. Thank you very much, guys, for joining us for this wonderful interview. Doc, we'll ask you one more question, no? Just to wrap this up. Again, if I am going through some problems, mental challenges, emotional challenges, if I feel I need to talk to someone, what can I do now? I know you shared that earlier, maybe just a quick bullet point. Who do we contact and how can we get help?
Again, talk to somebody that you trust, and so that you can be allow yourself to ventilate those emotions. And then if it comes to the point where that's still very, very difficult, please do not be afraid to seek out professional help. Okay, there are a lot of us now. I'm doing video conference consults at this point. I have I have patients scheduled in this afternoon already, and to be able to find ways to be able to do that. A lot of my colleagues are doing it, not just in the psychiatry field, but also in terms of counseling and psychology. So there are a lot of ways. So if it's really a matter of not being afraid to admit that something is not okay and sharing it.
Yeah. How do they contact you though, Doc? A lot of people are
asking. Do you have any platforms, Doc?
Okay. In terms of mine, so I do have, on Google, I have a searchable link in terms of my clinic. And then there's a mobile number there that they can contact, and para we can arrange if somebody needs to consult, we can arrange something like this. So my name is Dr. Kenneth Havate. So I think in my LinkedIn page, and I have a Google listing in terms of my clinic contact information, if ever.
Okay, Doc, what we will do to help you out, we will ask for those information, what you're willing to share. We will send that. We'll put that in the link right after this interview. Okay, that is a powerful talk, Doc. I learned a lot. You're really good as well. Thank you very much for all of those insights and ideas.
Well, thank you very much. It's a really great privilege for me to be able to reach out in this way, because I think we do have to think about our mental health at this time. And we do have to think about how we go through this crisis, not just in terms of our physical health, but also our mental health for ourselves and for the people we love. So please be mindful of that.
Yeah, thank you so much, Doc. There's a lot of learnings.
Yes, Shirley, what did you learn from this talk? Maybe very short lang, and then what do you want to say?
Yeah, I think it's really more of, parang God really orchestrated this one so that we can be in our present. No, because of our busy lives, we are focusing more of the past, we're focusing more of the future. But, having this kind of opportunity to have this quarantine and be with your family, it means that you have to treasure the present. Because even the mental health, it really speaks a lot, na parang, for us to prevent this kind of issues in terms of mental issues, we have to talk, we have to share our feelings with other people, and let's not be afraid. Because I think everyone will gonna go through this if we're gonna support each other. So it's very important that we treasure the gift of our life, the gift of our present. That's why it is called present. It means that it's a gift, so we must treasure it. So that's my
I love that.
Takeaway. Yes.
That's very Shirley. You can check out her, guys, she has her own store. It's called new beginnings, very optimistic, positive messages that you can wear anytime. That's new beginnings. Again, sa akin naman, what I learned is definitely that these times it's not practical at all to be the same person. If we allow fear to come in and really sabotage how we operate, I think that happened during the first days. I think we will not be able to go farther in life and really flourish and survive. And we may not be the person our family needs us to be and our community needs us to be. Right now, the best thing that we can do is to fully accept what's happening, to fully understand what's happening and realize what you can and cannot control. These times, I know it's really wrong na to, it could be wrong na to say na ba, others are going through, you know, this situation, there are deaths, their death tolls are already increasing, and I cannot understand that myself. But what we can do though is to pray for those people who are doing their efforts to stop this, and do our part by really flattening the curve, staying at home, being sane, being productive. We need to be the person that we need to be right now. So that we could be a productive, positive force. And if there are people who are going through some mental challenges, what I learned from Dr. Kenneth with what he shared earlier, he said that we should physical distance, not really social distance. You can still connect with your friends. Physical distance to protect yourself and protect others as well, but social distancing, we can always be social in this day and age. We're so fortunate to have technology like this to connect us to other people. And practice compassion, guys. Always remember, we can do this together. Doc Kenneth, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Doc Kenneth.
Thank you very much, Doc Kenneth. Thank you very much to NBU family who's watching here. Guys, thank you very much for the NBU people who's been supporting, and also thank you to Mental Health PH.
Mental Health PH.
Thank you for bringing over Doc Kenneth. If you guys want to contact Doc Kenneth, you can do anytime. We'll just share it in the links. Again, that's it. That's the first episode. Shirley, are you happy?
Yeah, I'm so happy. Kulang lang talaga sa oras, but I think all of those are learning bombs that we can apply.
We can apply. Ang galing mo, Doc. Thank you very much, Doc.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you very much. Thanks for the opportunity again. You take care and stay safe, everybody.
Thank you, Doc. Stay safe too.
And that's the first episode of Bold Moments Special Edition on our discussion about mental health. If you have further questions, just put them in the comment section below and we'll try to respond to that. Catch us tomorrow. We're going to have a talk. We're going to do live exercise. Are you ready for that, Shirley? We're going to do a live exercise.
Let's go!
With one of our NBU fellows.
Wow, so exciting.
Daniel. IG handle at Dan to Fitness. So he's going to share to us tips tomorrow on how we can be productive and physical at home.
Powerful.
Okay, guys, catch you guys tomorrow, 11:30 a.m. Again, always stay safe, stay at home, flatten the curve, and we can do this together, guys. Let's be united in fighting COVID. We are better than this. Thank you very much. Bye.
Stay safe. Bye.
Bye.